we need. The cat can cool down its own food. You know, sometimes just its name can get you excited about an invention. What about this one? The self-emptying vacuum cleaner. Self-emptying vacuum cleaner. I don't know about you, but I'm already intrigued.
Cleaning inside a heavy vehicle's cabin is critical for extending the life of the machine.
Using a portable vacuum cleaner to remove the grit and dirt means you have to carry it around with you, lug the waste and then empty the unit after the job. The filter often clogs and the unit needs regular maintenance.
My invention does the cleaning with ease, and when you finish the job, it empties itself.
The units are individually mounted on the outside of the cabin, powered by the vehicle's battery, and allows the vacuuming to happen with a long hose. When the vacuum's turned off, the collection chamber uses gravity to release the waste by itself. When the vehicle moves again, the vibration shakes the primary filter clean and reduces the maintenance on the unit.
I've invented the SEIV with plenty of grunt for dirty jobs.
Please welcome from Melbourne, Michael Herrett.
Hello,
Michael. Hello, James. Thanks for coming in. Now, these trucks, well, this is a cabin of a big truck like this very small truck.
Baby truck.
But they're on the road or on the dirt road 24-7. One driver gets out, another one gets in.
That's correct, yeah.
And there's a lot of dust and dirt around, so they've got to be kept clean. And as we saw in the package, sort of climbing up with a backpack, it takes a bit of time, doesn't it?
It does. It has to be, trucks have to be set aside to be cleaned, and they can't afford that time to have them down.
Yeah, whereas what you've done, you've made it really easy. You don't have to carry around anything. That's just permanently mounted there, right?
Mounted on the truck.
That's the unit. And once the driver has finished his or her shift, there's a little switch here. All they've got to do is grab the, grab it. Don't even have to get up. Turn it on. Put it this. Da 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 da, hoovering away, and then they're finished. They get out. They're finished. But we saw that beautiful bit there, self-emptying.
Yep.
And when the truck starts up, driving along, what's going to happen then?
It's going to clean the filter inside. It's going to vibrate the filter, so the filter cleans itself, and a bit more will drop out, and it'll be nice and clean for the next time around.
Lovely. Come across to the panel. And I would imagine that merely the presence of it and the fact that it is so kind of much easier now would probably prompt people to do it more often.
Well, that's the idea of it. OH&S want the cabins clean so people can have a clean environment to work in, so it's a safe environment, so there's nothing to slip on the floors and that sort of thing. It also helps the maintenance of the trucks. It helps the trucks and the excavators all last a hell of a lot longer.
Nice. Alison.
Michael, it makes so much sense to, you know, help maintain these machines that cost an absolute fortune to replace. What are the OH&S issues? I mean, just a bit of dust on you? Miners love that, don't they?
But in the mines, you get iron ore dust, you get coal dust, you get Irox dust. It's can be hazardous to the health. If you think of the miners of the olden days, they died from all this sort of thing. And now they don't want that to happen.
So they're bringing it in on their boots too, aren't they?
Yeah.
So there's no point in just air conditioning the cabin.
No, that'd only circulate the dirt and it wouldn't work.
Yeah.
Chris?
Yes, the obvious question, I guess, is you have to provide training to many truckies on how to use a vacuum cleaner, I guess. But is this a wet and dry vacuum cleaner? Or, you know, will it take up, you know, water and, you know, wet things and mud and so on, or only dry stuff?
It will cope with the wet as well. It's because it's got a tangential bypass motor in it.
A what?
It's a motor that will, anything that it sucks up, like water through the filter or anything like that, it will go out the side of the fans. It won't go up into the electrics of it.
And, okay, so when it gets into that cone arrangement at the bottom, is there a risk that it will clog? And how does the truck driver know that it's actually, you know, jammed and nothing's coming out and it's just building up?
No, because it self-empties every time you clean it.
Even with wet and mud?
Yeah, that'll only make it drop out more because of the weight. Because of the cyclonic effect, the dirt, heavy dirt goes to the outside and the light dirt sticks to the filter. So at the end of the day, when he's done the vacuuming, the heavy dirt drops out first, and then the light dirt drops off the filter when it gets shaken later on by the movement of the truck or excavator.
Now, in contrast, if you've got really coarse, rough particles, these particles can sort of come in with quite a bit of force. Is there a likelihood that it can actually start to tear through the filter itself?
At the moment, we have a denim-type filter in there, so it's like your jeans. It'll take a lot of wear and tear. Yeah. And these...
And if they get a hole, you just put a trendy patch on.
Yeah, that's right.
It's recommended that when they service the machine every 1,000 hours that they change the filter. And the filter costs $20.
Yeah. Summing up, Alison.
Oh, Michael, for this application, the design is absolutely spot on. And I love that it's just about shifting dirt from one spot to the other, which is what mining is anyway.
That's exactly right. Well, the first place I'd fit one of these is to my son's bedrooms, I think, because like mining trucks, the more automated the cleaning of those should be, the better.
Oh, I was going to say, okay, so that means that I could actually have one of these attached to my house. And in addition to self-emptying, it could be the self-doing vacuum cleaner. It could do it on its own as well.
That might be next year. That might be when you come back next year. Good on you, Michael. Please thank Michael Herrett. Thank you very much.
Thank you, James.
My pleasure.